Worry that this new law will cause an increase in people who are now driving under the influence of marijuana in Washington and actually probably spilling over here into Oregon,
yeah,
too.
And we wanted to know, how do police spot high drivers? Chris Holmstrom goes beyond the headlines to show us.
I'm out here in Clark County, where this time tomorrow, it'll be perfectly legal to purchase marijuana at a pot shop in Uptown Vancouver. And as you can imagine, there could be some stoned drivers on the roads, and law enforcement is ready to ticket. You're looking at video of a driver in Washington after several hits of marijuana.
They're going to exhibit signs and symptoms that are similar to a drunk driver.
And it's just as dangerous.
Narcotics, inhalants, cannabis.
That's why detectives like Jim Payne are nationally certified to be drug recognition experts, or DREs. They're trained to spot drivers under the influence of drugs, including marijuana.
Specifically, it's marked reddening of the whites of the eyes, the odor of marijuana, body tremors, eyelid tremors. Hey, I'm gonna bring that right up.
I learned when testing for drugs, they start out with the typical field sobriety test. If the driver fails that and there's no alcohol in the system, they move on to the next step. That includes checking their balance, eyes, and heart rate.
It tells us about what's going on inside somebody's body without actually getting inside of them to get the blood.
After that, a blood test, one of the most challenging for law enforcement.
We have to get somebody when they're under the influence of the active THC. Of the drug, and that's metabolized very quickly out of the body.
I found out officers have an average of about 2 hours to test for the active THC. After that, it's too late. I took the concerns that there may be more impaired drivers on the roads straight to those who smoke pot.
If you're gonna get buzzed, don't drive, because they regulate it the same as they do alcohol, so you just use the same mindset as you do for drinking alcohol.
I think you just have to be smart about it and have a designated driver. It's no different than that.
Reporting in Clark County, I'm Chris Holmstrom, Coin 6 News.